Hi guys, this is Sadiq from dwellbin.com, and in this video, we'll show you how to root the ArrowOS custom ROM based on Android 13 across any Android phone. Apart from that, we'll show you the steps to pass the SafetyNet test as well. So do keep in mind that while I am doing the steps across the Poco F4 device, but the steps are applicable across all the Android phone. Likewise, I'll be doing the steps on the ArrowOS ROM which is based on Android 13, but you could carry out these steps across all the versions of ArrowOS. So with that in mind, let's get started. First off, please take a backup of all the data on your phone. While the process will not wipe off any data, but still, let's take a backup to be on the safer side. Once that is done, let's get started. First off, you'll have to install the Android SDK platform tools folder. This is the official ADB binary given by Google and is required to execute ADB commands. So download it from the link given in my guide and then extract them onto your PC. In my case, I've done the extraction in E drive. You could extract them anywhere you want. Once that is done, you'll have to enable USB debugging. This is required to execute ADB commands. So let's carry out that task as well. So go to the settings menu on your phone. From the settings menu, you have to go to about phone and tap on build number 7 times. This will enable developer option. So now go back. Now go to system. You should now see developer option. Go there and enable the toggle next to USB debugging. You will get a prompt on your phone. Tap on OK. You might get one more prompt on your phone about the RSA key fingerprint, so tap on allow. With this, we have enabled debugging, and let's now verify the debugging connection as well. So go to the platform tools folder address bar, and from the folder address bar, just type in cmd and hit enter. This will launch the command prompt window inside the platform tools folder as you could see. Now type in adb devices and hit enter. Make sure you are getting a serial ID. If you are not getting a serial ID, then unplug and replug your phone from the PC. Disable and re-enable USB debugging. Tap on revoke USB debugging. Use the official USB cable that came with your phone and use the USB 2.0 port on your PC. So carry out these USB tweaks and make sure you are getting a serial ID. Once you are getting this ID, then you are good to go ahead. So next up, you will now have to download the latest Magisk APK file. So for that, you could refer to my guide as the time of recording. The latest APK version is version 25.2. So you could directly download the same from the my guide and jump over to this version, and you could also verify the change log from the GitHub. I have linked the official page as well. So download the APK, and once you have downloaded the APK, transfer them two places. The first is inside the platform tools folder, as you could see, this is the Magisk APK, and secondly, you also have to transfer it inside on your phone as well. So this is my Poco F4. Let me show you once again. So make sure to transfer the Magisk APK file onto your phone as well. If your phone is not visible on your PC, then bring up the settings menu and from there, tap on USB file transfer and checkmark file transfer. With this, your phone will now be visible on your PC and then you can transfer the APK. So download and transfer the Magisk APK onto your phone as well as in the platform tools folder. Once you have transferred in both these places, the APK which is there in the platform tools needs to be changed to a zip file. So just right click on the Magisk APK file and delete the APK from the end and change it to zip. You will now get the prompt on your PC, hit the yes button. So with this, we have converted the Magisk APK to Magisk zip and we could now sideload via recovery. On the other hand, the Magisk in the phone should be in the APK format itself. So the Magisk on the phone should be in the APK format, whereas the Magisk on the platform tools folder needs to be changed to zip format. Once you have done that task, your next course of action is to reboot your phone to the recovery mode. In other words, to the ArrowOS recovery. So let's now reboot our phone to the ArrowOS recovery as well. For that, you could either use the hardware key combination or the ADB command. I will be using the ADB command. So launch the CMD window inside platform tools and type in ADB reboot recovery and hit enter. Your phone should now boot to the ArrowOS recovery and it should only take a few seconds. So let's wait while that is happening. So as you could see, our phone is just about to boot to the recovery. And so we have got the Poco logo and now it should boot to the recovery mode. It's the ArrowOS recovery which comes built in with the ArrowOS ROM. So we are now in the recovery. Now you have to select apply update, then choose apply from ADB. With this, your phone is now in the ADB sideload mode. So now again, type in ADB devices and hit enter. Make sure you are getting a sideload key. So with this, you are now good to go ahead and you could now sideload the Magisk file. So the format is ADB sideload and the name of the file. In our case, the name is Magisk and it's for the zip format. Likewise, just to re-verify, it's better to rename it to something shorter. So for the ease of convenience, let's just rename the file to Magisk and remove the version number. So the complete name in our case becomes magisk.zip and we could now sideload the zip file. So just use the ADB sideload and file name and extension. So it's ADB sideload magisk.zip. the Magisk file will now be sent to our phone and subsequently flashed. So you will now get a signature verification failed message. This is completely normal, and we are getting this message because the Magisk file has not been signed by the ArrowOS team. In other words, the Magisk is not a part of ArrowOS, and you are getting this verification failed. You will get this error message if you flash or sideload any file which is not part of ArrowOS. For example, if you sideload gapps or any mod or any zip file, you are bound to get this warning message. It's completely normal, and just tap on yes. So it will now start the sideloading process, and as you could see, the process has started onto our phone. In the CMD window on your PC, the process will get stuck at 33%. That's completely normal and nothing to worry about. You will have to keep a track of the process from your phone itself. So as you could see, it's now mounting all the files and partition, and then it will flash the boot IMG file as well and patch the image file. So the process has now started, and as I've told you before, it's currently unpacking the boot image, and it's now patching the RAM disk and repacking the boot image, and flashing has now started, and the process is now completed. So you should get a done message in the bottom left from your phone. Likewise, onto your PC, you should get a total transfer 0.72x. So the process is now complete, and you can now boot your phone to the OS. So go back from the recovery screen and then tap on reboot system now. Your phone will now boot to the OS, and do keep in mind that as of now, the Magisk has only been installed in the backend. It has not yet been installed in the front end. So we will now have to install the Magisk in the front end as well, so that we could get a UI, GUI to interact with. And that was the reason why we have transferred the APK file to our phone as well. So we will now be installing the Magisk APK file using the app that we have transferred. So if you launch the phone now and go to the app drawer, you might not see the Magisk app. So currently you could see there is no Magisk app onto our phone. So we will now have to install the Magisk APK file. So launch the file manager app, and from there select the location where you place the Magisk file, tap on it, and then hit the continue button, and not tap on update. You are getting the update but option and not the install, because the Magisk has been installed in the backend. We just need the UI in the front end. So tap on update, and now Magisk will be updated to the latest version. Once done, just tap on open and then in allow notification, and it will now ask you to complete additional setup. So just tap on OK, and it will now flash some dependency in the backend and automatically reboot our phone within 5 seconds. So as you could see, our phone is now rebooting to the OS. So you don't have to do anything as of now, just wait for the time frame, and it will now flash the rest of the file, install the dependency, and reboot our phone back to the OS. And this process could usually take around 10 to 15 seconds. As you could see, it's now booting to the OS. And since it has now patched the stock boot IMG file, and it's now booting via the boot IMG file, the process could take up a few additional seconds. That is completely normal and nothing to worry about. And we are now in the ArrowOS boot animation. So let's now launch the and go to the app drawer. And as if I now launch the Magisk app, you could see our phone is now rooted via Magisk. So just to reconfirm the same, let me install the root checker app. You could install it from the Play Store as well. I'm using the simple root checker app which you could download from Play Store. So simply install the app, and now let's open it. And now if I tap on, so let's now check, if I now tap on verify root, I will get, should get a Magisk prompt. So just tap on grant, and as you could see, our phone is now rooted, and we now have a rooted ArrowOS ROM. So with this, we are done with the first half of the guide on how you could root the ArrowOS ROM. Let's now proceed ahead and try and pass the SafetyNet test as well. So before that, let me show you the status of the SafetyNet test. So for that, I'll be using the Yasnack app. You can install that app from the Play Store. So let me install the Yasnack app. Once done, I'll open the app. If I now launch the Yasnack app and tap on run SafetyNet test. So currently, as you could see, I'm failing both the tests, which are the basic integrity as well as the CDS profile match. So our ultimate aim will be to pass both these tests. So on that note, let's get started. So you could also refer to my guide as well. And on that note, so let me first show you. So first and foremost, you will have to hide the Magisk app. So for that, launch the Magisk app onto you from your phone. So let me now launch the Magisk app. Then tap on the settings icon at the top right, and then tap on hide the Magisk app. You will now have to enable the toggle next to allow from this source. Then go back and give the name, any name of your choice for Magisk. So as for this guide, I'll be using the name Droidwin. Just make sure to use a name which does not synchronize with the routing or modding section. For example, don't use a name such as root, ROM. Always use a basic, any common one will do. For example, I'm using Droidwin, and now tap on OK. It will now hide the Magisk app and should only take a few seconds. It's now asking to make a shortcut, so I don't want the shortcut. I will tap on cancel, and let me show you, the Magisk app is now renamed to Droidwin. So this is our new Magisk app as of now. So if I now launch it, so it's there. Next up, you have to install the systemless host. For that, go to the settings menu. From there, tap on systemless host and the module will be added to the Magisk. So now go back, go to the module section and make sure you are getting the systemless host. In my case, I'm getting this, so we are now good to go ahead. So we'll now have to enable Magisk. As you could see, currently it's showing as no next to Magisk. So we'll now have to enable Magisk. So tap on the settings icon. Then you have to enable the toggle next to Magisk. It will now ask you to reboot the phone. We'll do a reboot later on. Let's now put a pause on the reboot because we're flashing a module, and after that we'll do a reboot. So once you have enabled Magisk, go back, and now you have to install a module. So you could download the module from the guide of my link, and this is the name of the module is Universal SafetyNet Fix. Make sure to download the new version of the module, which is version 3.0. So download the module from GitHub and transfer it onto your phone. In my case, I already transferred the module. So as you could see, this is the module. So make sure to transfer the module onto your phone. And once that is done, launch the Magisk app. Then go to the module section, tap on install from storage. Now select the zip file, which in our case is the SafetyNet Fix module, and it will now be flashed. Once done, tap on the reboot button. So we are now restarting the module, a device, and with this, the Magisk should be enabled and our module is also flashed. So we did not restart our phone after enabling Magisk because we had to flash the module as well. So it's just to save time, we combined both these methods and now we are doing a restart. You could restart after enabling Magisk as well, but we are doing a restart now because we have done two methods into one. So with this, we have flashed the module and we have enabled Magisk as well. Let me show you both this task once again. So let's just to verify, launch the Magisk app, and as you could see, we are getting yes next to Magisk. So with this, Magisk has been enabled. Likewise, if I go to modules, you could see the module has been flashed as well. It's the SafetyNet Checks module. Once that is done, you now have to enforce and enable the deny list. So go to the settings icon and enable the toggle next to enforce deny list. Once that is done, go to configure deny list, and you now have to hide root from the following three apps. Let me show you the name of the app. It's the Google Play Store, Google Play Service, and Google Service Framework. In some cases, you might have the Google Play Product Service as well. If that is there as well, then you have to hide root from that as well. So in my case, I'm using a Poco F4 and only these three apps are there. So we'll be hiding the root from these three apps. Let me show you how this could be done. So once you're in this list, tap on the overflow icon at the top right and check mark show system apps. Now select the, let's now search for the Play Service app. So let me make, so first check mark the Play Service and expand it and enable the toggle next to all so that the blue bar at the top gets completely filled. As you could see, we have enabled all the service of Google Play Service. Likewise, do so for Google Play Store as well. Expand it and enable the toggle next to all so that all the process has been enabled. After that, we have to do so for Google Service Framework as well. So let's search that as well. So expand the Google Service Framework and make sure to check mark all these processes as well. So it's the Google Service Framework, Google Play Service, and Google Play Store. Once that is done, if the Google Play Protect is there on your phone, you will have to enable the toggle next to that as well. So just to verify, let me check out once. So if I check out onto my phone, just a minute. So as you could see, that app is not in my phone. So in my case, it's a Play Service, Play Store, and Play Service Framework. Apart from that, you could also hide the root from any banking and payment app that you want to use. So make sure to check mark and hide the app root from that app as well. And once that is done, you will now have to remove the data of those app as well. So in our case, we have hidden root from Play Store, Play Service, and Play Service Framework. So we'll now be removing the data of these three apps. For that, go to the settings menu on your phone. From settings menu, go to apps. Tap on see all apps, and first off, let's remove the data of Google Play Service. So go there, go to storage and cache section, tap on manage space, and tap on clear all data and hit OK. Now go back and select, again go back, now select Google Play Store, go there and go to storage and cache, tap on clear storage and tap on delete. After that, you have to remove the data of Google Service Framework. It is a system app, so go back and now tap on the overflow icon at the top right and select show system. It should now bring up the Service Framework app as well. So let's search for that. So service, it's the Services Framework. So as you could see, this is the Google Service Framework app. Go there, then go to storage and cache and tap on clear storage and tap on delete. Once that is done, you now have to remove the data of the app from which you have hidden root. This includes your payment or banking app of your choice as well. So make sure to remove the data of all those apps. So just to verify, it's the Play Service, Play Store, and Service Framework. And if Play Protect service was there on your phone, remove the data of that as well. After that, you have to remove the data of all the banking and payment type of your choice. Once that is done, you will now have to restart your phone. This restart is compulsory. So long press the power key and tap on restart. Our phone will now reboot to the OS and it should only take a few seconds. So let's wait while that is happening. And once the restart is done, we will now be verifying the result, and this time we should pass both the tests. So let me show you that as well. And as I have told you before, I'm using the Yasnak app for testing the integrity of the phone. You could use any app of your choice. So our phone is now booted to the OS, and it's a boot animation as you could see. So with this, our phone is now on the OS, and let's now verify the result. So let's unlock it, and I'm using the Yasnak app. Make sure you're online. Now type on run SafetyNet attestation, and as you could see, we are now passing both the tests, which is the basic integrity and CTS profile match. So guys, on that note, I round off this video. If you have any queries, do let me know in the comment section. And guys, please like this video and subscribe to the channel for more tips and tricks.